Amador Live. Thanks for standing by during that quick commercial. Like I said, great show today and amazing guests. Today we have Mark Reagan and Wendy Reagan. They're going to talk to us a little bit about Zeke's Benefit Dinner. And this is really important. I want you folks to tune in here and listen because this is an amazing cause and we all need to come together to help this child.
Cool. Well, Monique, what we're here for today is Ezekiel Reiling, 14-year-old freshman at Argonaut High School, was critically burned in a house fire over Christmas break. Basically, Zeke spent almost 3 months at Shriners Burn Center down in Sacramento. The first 3 weeks, he was on a ventilator, pretty questionable as to what the outcome was going to be. Wow. And remarkably enough, he pulled through, has made a great recovery, and was actually discharged about 2 weeks ago now.
Oh, that's good to hear.
And he's back up here in the community in Jackson. Now, the great thing is, with Zeke making the recovery so quick, he was able to come home, he's with his family again, mm-hmm. but the downfall is that he's still looking at outpatient treatment at Shriners 3 days a week, which is requiring the family to drive down there every day.
Right.
Okay, there's a lot of associated costs that are coming along with this.
I bet.
And, you know, I'll be honest, is that with everybody, the family's feeling the financial strain right now.
Mm-hmm.
And so what we've done is we've put together a benefit dinner for him on April 5th.
Okay.
And basically it's twofold. The first part is to come out and to help raise some money for this cause, to help show this young man that, you know, financially the community will support him. But even more so, it's also to come out and just show him that there is the support of the community, both financially and more importantly emotionally for
mm-hmm.
him. You know, one of the great things about this county is the people here. You know, I myself am a first generation. My wife's been here for 5 generations.
Oh, wow.
And one of the things that she first brought up when this happened was the way that this community is able to rally around people.
It is so true.
And we just want Zeke to see that physically.
Mm-hmm. You know, in a lot of other counties, because Amador County is small, we can see how the community comes together. A lot of other counties, you know, they'll do a little something here or there, but that community feel isn't present because they're just too big and too spread out. But here in Amador County, I've noticed the most that when there's some sort of crisis or need, you know, we publicize events like this, and then people come together and support each other, because you never know if you're going to be the person in the situation with need. And so that's really, really important to consider, is that we can help this young man and his family. You know, insurance doesn't pay for everything. In fact, there's a lot of costs that aren't paid for at all by insurance, and especially the ones with travel back and forth. You know, if they have to stay up in the area, you have to eat out when you're up there. And I'm sure there's a lot more other expenses that I don't even know about. So I think it's really important. So we want to come and help Zeke, and the date of the dinner is?
It's April 5th. It's going to be at the Italian Picnic Grounds at Sutter Hill.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to open the doors at 5:30. We have a no-host bar. We're going to serve dinner at 6:30.
Mm-hmm.
And then after that, we are going to have a raffle, dessert auction, which we borrowed that idea from another benefit,
mm-hmm.
and we're going to have a silent auction, as well as a band. We have Matt and Damon from Forever Gold Rush and Freeze Out playing acoustically.
Oh, fabulous.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
great, great. What's for dinner?
We're having chicken and tri-tip,
mm-hmm.
pesto and salad, bread, and then we're going to prepare some, you know, drinks like tea and water and all that kind
mm-hmm.
of stuff.
Well, that sounds like a lot of fun. So if anything, you know, go out there and enjoy the fabulous food and pick up some great auction items. You know, that's really neat. What are you looking for right now? Do you need auction items?
You know, honestly, the community's been great at coming forth with raffle prizes, with
mm-hmm.
auction items. The support there has been great. The biggest way that we could support Zeke right now is just encouraging people to purchase tickets
okay.
and to come out and physically show their support for him.
Right.
So tickets are available.
Okay.
We have them at 4 locations throughout the county. They're at Sterling Auto,
mm-hmm.
Kaizen Martial Arts right here in Jackson,
right.
Barron's Furniture, as well as Argonaut High School.
Fabulous. So easy to locate.
Exactly.
Okay. Very good. And the tickets are how much?
Tickets are $35 a ticket,
mm-hmm.
or you can get a table of 8 for $280.
That's a deal. Yeah. So, you know, really reasonable, and that money is solely going to probably cost of food, right? And then the rest goes to
exactly.
Zeke.
Pretty
everything,
much.
Everything
yeah.
above and beyond. We've had a caterer, Tim Swisher, who's generous enough to donate his time.
Oh, great.
So really the cost is just for the food itself,
mm-hmm.
and everything above and beyond that's going to go directly to Zeke and his grandmother, Dottie.
Wow, I'm so yeah. glad to hear that. Poor Dottie, that's just an emotionally trying thing to go through, you know, with her grandson being, you know, in a very bad way there for quite a while, and then still the recovery is long.
Long recovery.
Long, long recovery.
Definitely. So. She was fortunate enough, she was able to stay with him down at Shriners. She was there the whole time with him.
Aww.
And now he's with her back here at home. Mm-hmm. But definitely the emotional toll it's taken on the family has been incredible.
Jeez, I can't even imagine. Yeah. And so you folks know Zeke from Kaizen, is that right?
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, we all, our whole family trains there at Kaizen. Great family atmosphere, and in fact, the owners, Anthony and Harmony, are very, very big supporters of this. They're very involved with this.
Mm-hmm.
And again, it's just extending out the family atmosphere to everyone that trains there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's really great. And I love how just even within Kaizen, people come together to try to make this happen. Anybody else involved in creating this event?
There's been many people helping us, donating various things. The Jackson Rancheria has donated printing of tickets and flyers and brochures.
Mm-hmm.
The Board of Supervisors has helped us secure the fairgrounds, and many, many other businesses has helped us, you know, donate raffle prizes and money.
Mm-hmm.
To help us
get
going.
Just take cash to create it, definitely.
Yeah.
No, the support from the community has been incredible for them.
So let's wrap up one more time the event, what's going to take place, your itinerary. Let's hear it one more time, please.
So what we're looking at is on April 5th, doors are going to open at 5:30,
mm-hmm.
and we're going to start off no host bar beginning at 5:30. Dinner will be served at 6:30. We're looking at chicken, tri-tip, pesto, salad, bread, some non-alcoholic drinks as well.
Mm-hmm.
As dinner starts to conclude, we do have a raffle, a dessert auction, a silent auction that'll all be taking place.
Right.
And once everybody's wrapped up with that, we have Damon and Mason from Forever Gold Rush, as well as Freeze Out playing acoustically.
Great.
So that everybody can relax and hopefully enjoy the show.
Yeah, enjoy the music, enjoy the show, a little bit of dancing maybe, you know, a lot of fun.
Exactly.
Sounds really, really good.
So, and the biggest part is that since Zeke's out of the hospital now, he'll be there.
Oh,
and he wants
to ask
one-on-one
about that.
Go around and thank everybody for all the support they've offered him.
That is so great that he's out of the hospital. And I'm sure with Zeke seeing just the outpour of love from the community, that's going to be really, really great for his heart and, you know, for him to continue to carry on and be strong. And so he's quite an amazing young man.
Oh, yeah. He is. His spirits have been great throughout all this.
That is so awesome. Well, I'm looking forward, especially to have him see all the people that are out there supporting him and loving him. And I want to thank both you and Wendy for organizing this event, for being his stronghold in this event, providing so much for him and his family. You guys are amazing people too, and it's an absolute thrill to have you on the show.
Thank you.
So, thank you very much.
With
Thanks
that, we're just going to head out for a moment, and we'll be right back with you. Stay with us.